2022, PESA, Poland's national rail company, put a hydrogen-fueled shunting locomotive into service. Today, we are at PESA's rail yard in Bydgoszcz, Poland, where we will learn why the company built a hydrogen train, how they built it, and what role Worthington played in the project. Today, I'm talking with Mr. Maciej Rzeszkowiak. Hello, Mr. Rzeszkowiak. Maybe we could start with whether I'm pronouncing your name right, and then tell us what you do at PESA and the role you played in the project.
I would like to welcome you here in PESA, our headquarters in Bydgoszcz. And according to my name, you did it perfectly. Pronunciation was good. I'm Maciej Grzeszkowiak, and I'm a director for strategic projects and communication here.
Why did you build a hydrogen shunting locomotive? What can it do that diesel or electric trains can't? As you can see, I'm a kid. So could you please explain to me so I can tell my friends?
As you mentioned before, PESA is the Polish biggest train producer, and we have a new strategy 2030. And it one of the key points of the strategy is to be as ecological as possible and to reduce the footprint, the carbon footprint of our company. But most of all, to produce trains which are ecological and environmentally friendly. The hydrogen shunting locomotive is exactly the same like the diesel ones. It has the same power, the same speed, may pull the same number of wagons, but there is one huge difference. It is emission-free because it is powered by hydrogen and not the diesel engine.
How do you refuel it? Where does the hydrogen come from? And where does it go on the train?
Well, hydrogen is produced by energy or gas companies, and they deliver it to us on a special mobile refueling station. Then we have typical refueling, like you may see at the petrol station when you refuel the car with the gas. There is a special pocket connection. The hydrogen is transferred to the hydrogen tanks, from them to a fuel cells, which produce energy that power the engine. Worthington has delivered us hydrogen tanks and a fueling system. It was important that we choose that partner because of their experience and knowledge. But there is one more thing which was important for us. They have their design and manufacturing center here in Poland, in Słupsk. When you replace one diesel train with the train which is powered by hydrogen, you will reduce carbon 1,000 tons a year.
How does this project help us with climate goals? Does the train have solar panels?
So it's a huge effect on the environment. And of course, with every year we use much more ecological materials to produce the train, as you can see here. And what's important for the passengers, the electric zero emission trains are much more quieter than the diesel ones. So if you sum it all up, when people use public transport, especially trains or trams, they really support saving the planet.
What more is needed to make a real difference in the rail sector, and how can partners like Worthington help?
Well, the next step for all the rail sector is to produce and introduce passenger trains powered by hydrogen. We are just working on such a project and the train will be powered by electric traction and fuel cells. The partners like Worthington are not only the suppliers, they supply us with the equipment, but what was much more important for us, that their team became a partner. Their people became members of our team. They supported us with experience, knowledge, and we have shared the same passion for producing things, in this situation trains, but generally to produce trains which are ecological and will help us to save the planet.
This is great. I can't wait to tell my classmates, who are also kids, about PESA and everything I learned. I also have a present for you.
Thank you have you seen it? Thank you very much.
Mr. Rzeszkowiak, do you have any closing comments?
Well, I will have one. As we are sitting in a train and I'm from the rail sector, I will answer with the comments like this. Stop using diesel cars. Use the public transportation. Use electric or hydrogen trams and trains. Then we really will reduce the carbon footprint.
What have we learned today? In Poland and across our planet, Worthington and partners are driving or shunting sustainability.